though walking in darkness, we've seen a great light. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
And they all lived happily ever after. The end. That was a good one. All right, Jake, it's time for you to get some sleep now.
Wait a minute, Mom, don't leave yet.
What's going on? You need to get some sleep, bud. It's almost past your bedtime.
I'm scared. That book made me nervous. And I'm thinking of all the things I'm afraid of.
Well, like what?
Well, let's see. There's airplane, bees, carnivores, dogs, electric shocks, fires, ghosts, hexes, invertebrates, nightmares, orthodontist, poison, questions, roller coasters, spiders, teasing, under my bed, violence, worms, x-rays, yellow fever, and Zoom.
Did you just list your fears in alphabetical order? Wow. Well, I can relate. I feel afraid sometimes too.
So how do I feel better right now? I can't sleep while I'm scared.
Well, stories help. When I'm afraid, or if I'm worrying about something, I remember that I'm part of a story that's so much bigger than myself. And God's story is full of people who were sometimes afraid too. You know, I think I have time to tell you one more story. This part of God's story is during a time when many people were afraid of many different things. Just like us, it all begins in Nazareth, a town in Galilee, with a woman named Mary.
Oh, hi. Welcome. Welcome to my home. Did you want to talk to me? We haven't met, have we? Do you want to hear what I have to say?
I do. Pardon me. Let me start over. Greetings, favored one. God is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Now you are going to have a baby boy. You will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. His kingdom will have no end.
How can this be? How is this going to happen?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you and the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. Also, your relative Elizabeth is going to have a baby. Even though people thought it would be impossible, but nothing is impossible with God.
Was all of that a question?
Good question. Yes.
Well, I guess you are asking me to do this. Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to this message.
Mary is pregnant? How is that possible? We aren't even married. And under the law, it's not good. It's not good at all. She claims that this child, the child that she carries, is actually the child of God. My only option is to marry her, then divorce her quietly. That will save my reputation, at least. But she will be disgraced. I don't know what to do, and I'm afraid. Oh, Mary.
Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to get married. God's Holy Spirit has made Mary pregnant. She will have a son, and you will name him Jesus. God saves, because he will save his people from their sins.
I'm going to marry Mary? I'm going to marry Mary! And we're going to have a baby, and I'm going to name him Jesus. I'm going to be a dad. I've got pep.
Hold on, I have a question. Why is Joseph packing a bag? Do angels still visit people in their dreams? Why is everybody making such a big deal about this baby? It's just a baby.
Yeah, I don't know the answer to most of those questions. This is a bigger than life kind of story, and there are a lot of unexplainable and miraculous parts of it.
Okay, that sounds like what Pastor Ollie would say.
Well, good. I'm glad I sound like Pastor Ollie, because sometimes we just don't have all the answers to the questions. And now I do know the answer to one of those questions. Why is Joseph packing? To answer that, we will need to meet the emperor.
Citizens of Rome, it is I, your Lord and Savior, Good Shepherd, Light, Way, Prince of Peace, Caesar Augustus. First, I want to say to you that you're welcome for all the great things I've done for you. There has never been an emperor more powerful and glorious than me. Yes, that is right. My empire is vast. You people are obedient. I am saving you all. All of you, and you owe me so much, so much. Citizens, I want to count you. Yes, I want to count you. Yes, let's get a good head count so that you can all pay me what I am owed. Go to your hometowns. Register your families so that you can show proper appreciation to my awesomeness. I decree it to be so. Yes, yes, and so I say farewell, my faithful children. May you know my magnificent ways. Farewell!
Okay, the good news is, I think I found a place for us to stay.
Finally, this baby is not going to wait much longer. Is it my favorite one? The one with the good breakfast?
Not exactly. It was full.
What are we going to do? Sleep outside with the shepherds? Sleep in a stable with the donkeys?
What? No. We wouldn't do that.
Joseph, this baby is coming soon.
I know. The guest rooms are all full, but I have found an innkeeper who will let us stay in a small place in his home.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it's a nice space. Lots of hay. Maybe a few animals, too.
All right, let's do this.
Okay, stop there.
What?
I don't think I want to hear about the birth part.
Okay, well, we can talk about that later. The Bible doesn't really tell us anything about the birth anyway. It just says that Mary had the baby, wrapped him in strips of cloth, and placed him in a feeding trough. That's it. But those are important details to remember for the next part of our story. It takes place in a field.
Okay, keep going.
There were shepherds living outside in the fields nearby, watching over their sheep, and they were about to be frightened by some powerful messengers from God. But they would soon realize that they did not need to be afraid.
Glory to God in the highest.
Ahem, ahem. Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Is this thing even working? Am I on mute?
Are you people even listening?
Do not be afraid. I have a good news that everyone will be happy when they hear it.
Today in the city of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
Good news for all the people. The Messiah is born, a Savior. So, you saw that, right?
Yes, I did.
Well, we're going, right?
Yes, we're going. We have to go.
Do we bring the sheep?
I think we have to.
What are those signs again?
A baby.
Wrapped in strips of cloth.
Lying in the manger.
You two feet, come on.
That was a miracle.
It was exactly how the angel had described.
We have seen something amazing tonight. I don't know about you, but the world feels like it's changing.
Yeah, but why do you think we got to see it? Nobody cares about us. We're shepherds, we're poor, and we don't have very much power.
I have no idea, but the baby mother Mary acts like this was
what this baby can do.
Hey, shepherds, was that star there before? I don't think I saw that one last night.
Hello, and welcome to our observatory. We are the wise men.
Wise people.
The Magi.
Scientists.
Astronomers. We study the stars. We study the stars so well that when something changes, we notice immediately.
And we just noticed a new star. We must follow our scientific instincts and find out why there is a new star in the sky.
We now begin our journey.
Are we there yet?
You literally just asked that.
Now?
Yes, it looks like we're here. Here it is, Bethlehem. Let's look up
the local king so we could get some more information.
Did somebody say king?
That would be me. I'm the big cheese around here. Everybody is talking about it. They all say that I'm the most powerful king, the best king that Bethlehem has ever seen.
We got it, best king ever.
So, we're here because we are looking for the newly born king, the child born king of the Jews. We observed his star as it's rising.
And we have come to honor him.
Will you excuse me for a moment? I need to make a call. Hey, put me through to my smart people. Hi, this is your king, the very best king. I need to know, according to your research, where is the Messiah supposed to be born? Bethlehem. Are you sure? Bye.
Wise folks. So yeah, this is great. Go on and find this child and pay him honor. And get back to me about this so I too can honor him.
Sure. Okay. We can do that.
Let's get out of here.
When we left Herod, he decided to sit around and be jealous and plan his revenge.
He felt very threatened. There was a new leader that people were excited to meet. But we found Jesus and brought gifts to the special child. We brought gold.
Frankincense.
And myrrh.
Usually these gifts are for royalty.
Now for people.
Grown men.
But we brought these gifts to a tiny, weak, oppressed child. Even though we didn't know what was going on, we knew he was important.
The good news is we're going to turn everything upside down.
Oh, and by the way, we didn't return to that wicked King Herod.
Nope, no way. We were warned in a dream to take a different way home. You might say we took the scenic route. And now we return to watching our stars.
Those wise people were really brave. They honored the king God had chosen, brought him presents, disobeyed the orders of King Herod, and made it home safely.
Yes, they were brave and determined. Everyone in the story was, I think, from Mary and Joseph to the shepherds and the magi. They all recognized that the birth of Jesus was going to change the world. Jake, are you feeling safe and sleepy yet? Because our story's coming to an end.
Yes, I feel safe and sleepy, but this really isn't the end.
No? Why not? It's bedtime. We're getting to the end.
Mom, this is just the beginning. Jesus is born, he grows up, he changes water into wine, he teaches, he heals, he flips tables, he...
Yes, you're right. Jesus' birth is just the beginning. We have a lot to talk about, but for tonight, since it's getting late, let's focus on this one special moment, this one night that brought us Jesus.
Okay, that makes sense. This is a good story.
God's story is unfolding more good news each and every day. And in the end, all things will be made right. That doesn't mean that we won't be afraid along the way, but we can trust that love and justice will have the final word. Speaking of the final word, let's have a final word from Mary, the mother of Jesus.
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For you, God, have looked with favor on the lowliness of your servant. Surely, from now on, all generations will be called blessed. For you, the Mighty One, have done great things for me. And holy is your name. Your mercy is for those who fear God from generation to generation. You, O God, have shown strength with your arms. You have scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. You, O God, have brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted the lowly. You have filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. You have helped your servant Israel. In remembrance of your mercy, according to the promise you have made to our ancestors, to Abraham and Sarah, and to their descendants forever.